So is she in the country or she's out of the country? What is it?
Well, according to two official press releases from the Bureau of Immigration and from PAOC, the Presidential Anti-Organized Crime, it seems to be that she is not in the country anymore. She's no longer in the country. She left on July 17, apparently by an airline called Batik Air. And Batik Air only flies to Manila. It flies to from Manila to KL. So most likely that she went through the airports of Manila, if the information is accurate. And so two government agencies issued official press releases saying that she's no longer in the Philippines.
Okay. I'm curious, Senator, how do they know that she's no longer in the Philippines when the Bureau of Immigration centralized database has no record of Guo actually leaving the country despite a lookout order that was issued in July?
Well, Karen, this is where accountability should come in, and we will definitely hold the government officials to account. Most importantly, the Bureau of Immigration and CAAP, the Civil Aeronautics Aviation Authority. These two government agencies have jurisdiction as well as supervision and control of all of our airports. Mm-hmm. That means everyone that goes in and goes out goes through their system and goes through their procedure. So we have to hold them to account. Having said that, if she indeed went through the Philippines via Batik Air, went through Manila via Batik Air, then there should be CCTVs, and those should be disclosed to the public.
Okay. I'm curious, would you know which airport at this point Senator Sherwin Batik Air, Air takes off from? Is it NAIA Terminal 3, 1? Would you know?
I'm not very sure on that same particular detail, but we went through our information. We just did a cursory research through the internet, and apparently Batik Air only flies from Manila.
Uh-oh.
And based on the information yesterday and also from PAOC, that she took Batik Air out of Manila. So that means she went through the Manila airports.
Okay. And Senator Risa Ontiveros has said she used her Guo Huaping passport, the Chinese passport. Is that correct?
Apparently so, but in the Malaysian, also in the same presentation by Senator Risa, we saw that yesterday, we saw in her presentation that the Malaysian authorities detected Alice Guo with a Filipino passport entering Malaysia.
Uh-oh.
So most likely, she probably used her two passports interchangeably. Maybe to evade Manila, she used her Chinese passport, but to go around ASEAN. Because ASEAN, if you have a Filipino passport, you don't need the visa to go around, and it's easy to go around ASEAN. She probably used her Filipino passport.
Okay. So, Senator Sherwin, what is the status of Alice Guo for her to actually be able to enter another country? For example, she wasn't on alert when it came to Interpol. Clearly, there was a whole departure order against her, but she was able to evade and beat that. But are other ASEAN countries have they been informed in any way about Alice Guo, or she was technically free to travel to any other ASEAN country? There was no alert.
Well, Karen, there's no whole departure order yet
on
Alice Guo because there's no court order. Mm-hmm. There's a lookout bulletin issued against her by the Bureau of Immigration. But there are at least five cases ongoing against her. And all of these cases, if she will not appear personally, she would be tried and convicted of all of those crimes. This is a temporary setback for the country, I believe. And her world will become smaller and smaller because of those cases. And we have extradition treaties between those countries. And if ever we get a conviction, and I'm very confident that we will, we can already file for an extradition process so that she will be extradited back to the Philippines and tried here.
But Senator Gatchalian, actually there's what's been exposed here is the gaps within the process, right? Considering there was such a high-profile Senate investigation on Alice Guo, and there were cases filed against her in the Philippines, don't you think a hold departure order should have been issued against her? I mean, hold departure orders have been issued against individuals with lesser crimes, right? And here's Alice Guo. It's a shock that there's no hold departure order that was issued against her. Which agency or who was responsible for that?
Well, Karen, in our process, the courts is the only one who can issue a hold departure order against an individual.
DOJ have asked? Should the DOJ have asked?
Well, the cases have been filed. The human trafficking cases have been filed, and the process is already ongoing. Definitely, the whole departure order will come on later on. But apparently, she beat us to it. She managed to leave the country without that court order.
Yeah. And, ideally, who should have filed for the whole departure order? Should it have been the DOJ at this point?
It's the DOJ who should file that. And the other government agencies, because if you have a case against an individual and the case is... has already judgment, then you can file a hold departure order so that that individual cannot leave the country. Okay. But Karen, there's a twist to this. Let me just...
Go, what's the twist? Yeah.
Because the twist is she filed her counter affidavit on August 18. And this counter
August 14.
August 15.
She went to the notary public.
Correct. So she filed her counter affidavit on August 15. This is a reply against the human trafficking case against her. And she went to the notary public on August 14. Mm. And this notary public, when I sent my staff to ask the notary public and interview the notary public, told us and claimed that Alice Guo went to his office personally to file that notary public or to request for that notarization. So apparently, on August 14, based on the testament of the notary public, Alice Guo is still here in the country.
So
that's the other twist.
Yeah, so that's why my first question was, so Senator, is she in the country or out of the country? Because also of what you exposed in the Senate. So ang tanong ko, I know that you will be calling the notary public, right? But
yes.
Does this mean that the notary public was able to get a fingerprint, for example, of Go Hua Ping to ascertain that it's one and the same individual that he claims to have seen?
Well, in our process, in the rules of the Supreme Court, the person should personally appear in front of the notary public. And the person, if you read the notary statement, should personally know this person. And I would assume that
pero may fingerprint ba yon sa notary public?
Walang fingerprint.
Ah, wala. Eh, paano kasi kung kamukha lang?
Well, that's a different story altogether.
Okay.
That's an extreme criminal mind working already that you sent someone who looks like you. But definitely, this is still an ongoing inquiry. And definitely, we need to ask the notary public if indeed, he saw Alice Guo in his office, and if he has other pieces of evidence that will corroborate to his.
But then, interestingly, Senator Sherwin, it seems you said it's an extreme criminal mind, but this is the same woman who claims, I grew up in a farm.
Correct.
Right? This is that same woman, I don't know my mother, kasambahay nanay ko, and it turns out all along, she was a Chinese national. So it is a criminal mind.
She's very sophisticated. After all of these things happening, she is very sophisticated criminal mind. And I believe that even prior to all of this, she already has had plans of escaping and... Yeah. Probably she had planned on how to escape the country and evade the law. And we're dealing with this type of person in the country who has managed to get a Filipino citizenship through fake documents.
So that's one. And let's talk about Batik Air. If Batik Air essentially flies out of Manila using our regular airports, because remember, there were some senators who said she must have taken a chartered flight, etc. And it turns out it's not true. She actually went through our airports. Who is liable? Right?
Well, this is a slap on the face of the Bureau of Immigration as well as the CAAP and the manager of our airports. Because in this case, NAIA, you cannot just walk in the airport undetected. It's impossible. And you cannot just get out of our airports undocumented. You have to pass through immigration. You have to pass through countless number of CCTVs. And there must have, we must have some traces of that movement inside our airport all the way to boarding the plane.
So that's one thing. And then Senator Risa Ontiveros said, after Kuala Lumpur, she took Jet Air to go to Singapore, possibly once again using the Filipino passport, right? Because this is ASEAN, met with the family and took a ferry to Indonesia. So ang tanong ngayon, if Alice Guo is still in Indonesia, hypothetically, what are the country's options? Do we have an extradition treaty? I mean, considering she left without a whole departure order, what do we really have on her to ask countries to cooperate to send her back?
Well, this is, again, a temporary setback for the country. The cases should continue. And even the Senate will file our own case against her on perjury as well as disobedience. So her world will shrink. And the long arm of the law will eventually get her. As far as I know, we have extradition treaties with Indonesia and with most of the ASEAN countries. So once convicted, she will be extradited back to the Philippines and tried and punished here.
Okay. But I wanted to ask you, Senator Gatchalian, if from Indonesia, Alice Guo finds her way to China, China has 1.4 billion people. And considering what the Philippines is going through with China, with its foreign policy, don't you think that will be much harder to actually pin down Alice Guo?
Well, in my opinion, on the contrary to that theory, Karen, China has one of the most strictest laws in terms of gambling. In fact, they just updated their law a few years ago to expand the coverage of gambling by mere presence or mere investing or mere association with gambling can be prosecuted. So my theory is if she goes back to China, she will be prosecuted there because she participated heavily in POGOS, which is illegal in China.
Yeah, except China is such a huge country too. It's also easier to hide in China.
Correct. That's another angle that we should look at. If she can hide or she can erase her identity once inside China.
Okay. So number two, next question. What about the counsel of Alice Guo? I mean, yes, each and every person has a right to counsel. And attorney Stephen David was interviewed and he said he called Alice Guo. That's his story. Tinanong niya, oh, nasa Pilipinas ka pa ba? Kasi kung wala na, umalis ka, that's your option. I just have to change my strategy. At this point, are any of Alice Guo's counsels, could they be held liable for anything?
Well, Karen, apparently, from what I hear from the interviews of Attorney David, he is communicating with Alice or with Guo Huaping through the telephone.
Yeah.
And from what I gather from his interviews is he himself have not seen Alice Guo physically in the country. Everything is communicated through telephone and through the cell phone. So that's from what I gathered in his interview. So in that part, in that case, he cannot be held liable because he himself doesn't know that if whether Alice Guo is still here or she's out of the country.
Okay. But if a lawyer has been proven, if her counsel's been proven to aid her in leaving the country, are they liable?
Oh, definitely. Anyone for that matter. If you are hiding a person from justice or aiding a person to evade justice, then you are liable, whether you're a lawyer or an ordinary person, mm-hmm. because it's your job to also abide by the law. And if anyone has information about go-hopping, then that person should give the get authorities the information of her whereabouts.
Okay, here's an interesting question from Ms. Vivian Yuchenko, who's watching us right now. And she asks, why wasn't her passport canceled in the first place? The Philippine passport, that is a very good question. Why not? Who should have been, which agency should have been responsible for canceling her passport after the expose in the Senate that she's actually go-hopping and she's not really a Filipino citizen? Who should have done that?
Karen, it's a process. Unfortunately, it's a long process. Mm. Her passport, the issuance of her passport was based on her birth certificate. Mm. And in order to cancel her passport, you have to cancel the birth certificate first. Mm. Unfortunately, you have to go through the courts, meaning there's a due process to cancel her birth certificate. And the OSG has already started that process. They've already filed cases against her to cancel her birth certificate. Once her birth certificate is canceled, then automatically the passport will be canceled. But right now, if her birth certificate is still outstanding, that passport will still stand.
Oo. So, Senator, tama yung sinabi niyo eh, na utakan tayo. Sabi ni Senator Risa, para tayong niluto, pinrito, sa sariling mantika. Honestly, a whole departure order, would this have made all the difference?
Well, definitely. Karen, and it's not only a national shame, but this is a global shame for our country because the whole world is watching this saga. In fact, if you just go through the internet, a lot of the international news agencies picked up this story, and they have a lot of interest on this story. And now they will report that go-hopping has managed to escape authorities through our regular airports. This is really a national shame and a global shame. And we will not take this lightly. We will hold the government agencies to account and we will make sure that heads will roll because of this incident.
So heads will roll. Senator Gatchalian, heads will roll.
Yes, definitely. And I will not take this lightly because this has been ongoing. The media has covered this on a regular basis. It's high profile. And you don't tell us that she can just walk into an airport, go through the immigration without being detected, the CCTV, board the plane and leave the Philippines. That's purely BS.
Mm-hmm. Okay. On that note, when is the next hearing? I'm assuming, sir, you will be calling airport authorities, CAAP, Bureau of Immigration, because you want to know everybody on duty on July 17. And I'm curious, was she even caught on CCTV? Because I read a news article that said the area where she walked had no CCTV. I mean, is that even true?
That's totally BS, Karen.
Okay.
If that really happened, then she was aided by airport officials who knew that area has no CCTV. Mm-mm. No. So in other words, she cannot just walk in the airport and leave without being aided by our own government officials. And that's the focus right now.
Mm-hmm. On that note, Senator Sherwin Gatchalian, between us, I'm just curious, well, when is the next hearing?
We're still gathering information. Like I said, there are other twists that's starting to come in, and we're looking at that and validating that also. The other twist about the notary public is something quite interesting, and we have to put all these pieces together. So we're scheduling it soon.
All right. On that note, Senator Sherwin Gatchalian, thank you so much for joining us on Head Start today.
Thank you, Karen.
All right.